Minnesota's delegation at the Republican National Convention cheering on Minnesota Congressman and Majority Whip Tom Emmer this evening as he took the stage on the convention's second day. Emmer touting Republican accomplishments over the last 4 years and a push for Trump to win in November. He pointed to policies that Republicans have held off over the last 2 years with a majority in the House of Representatives, calling for progress and saying Minnesotans are ready for change.
I know firsthand that Minnesotans can't afford 4 more years of Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. That's right. Which is why I'm confident that we will make history this November when we turn Minnesota red for the first time in 50 years.
Let's check in with now John Croman live in Milwaukee at the RNC. John, I understand other Republican leaders from Minnesota were there as well tonight.
Yeah, we were with the Minnesota delegation, Julie, as Tom Emmer was speaking, and the delegates we talked to are just very pumped up, very excited. They say this convention is much more energized than the past GOP get-togethers they've been to. They like the pick of J.D. Vance, adding him to the ticket, and former Rep. Kelly Fenton told us that the attempt on the former president's life has really unified Republicans.
People are thinking what could have been, but more than anything, it's unified people more behind Trump. And I think one thing that we're going to see from this is any supporter of Trump will make sure that they don't sit home. They will actually go vote for him.
I think it's going to be a winning ticket. We're very positive about J.D. Vance's addition to the ticket. We think he's going to help carry Minnesota. Tom is exactly right. We think Minnesota is going to turn red this fall with Donald Trump and J.D. Vance at the top of the ticket.
Now, the reason that would be so significant is the last time Minnesota went with a Republican presidential candidate was 1972, when incumbent former President Richard Nixon carried the state as part of a landslide victory over Senator George McGovern from South Dakota. Donald Trump came very close in 2016, within a point and a half of Hillary Clinton, but he lost to Joe Biden in 2020 by 7 points. Now, the reason the Republicans are having this convention in Milwaukee, it's part of their strategy to win Wisconsin and Minnesota and other Midwest states that have been known in the past collectively as the Blue Wall. Julie, so 2 more days to go, and like I said, the Minnesota delegates are really excited about what they're seeing here.
All right. Thank you, John. We'll check back tomorrow. You can watch the Republican National Convention live on KARE 11 Plus or our streaming app, Roku, Fire, and Apple TV.